subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
People have to live in unity.
We are still in transition.
Civil society has been decimated.
Of course, we rely on media.
And I think the government has not done enough.
The international community has failed to.
India is well known around the world for its culture and heritage. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I am your host Emma, and today in our episode of My India, we will take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Popularly known as the Temple City of India, Odisha's capital Bhubaneswar hosts a number of festivals throughout the year to commemorate the living heritage of dance, sculpture and art. One among them is the Mukteshwar Dance Festival, a three-day extravaganza that invites some of the best Odissi dancers to perform in the complex of legendary Mukteshwar Temple.
The graceful moves, the trinklets of anklets and symphony of the music against the backdrop of the magnificent 10th century temple makes up for a magical evening during the annual Mukteshwar Dance Festival. Celebrating the unrivaled charisma of Odissi dance form, the festival falls in the month of January and coincides with Makar Sankranti, an ancient Indian festival that celebrates the solar cycle. Every year, a number of Odissi dancers of national and international repute grace the occasion with their performances, which are dolled up with lights and colorful backdrops for giving a perfect view.
This temple is very, very old. It was built in 10th century, and it is Shaiva Pitha, a Shiva's temple, and there is a Siddhi Ganesh. So he is there to take away all the sins. See, in Konark, it has been planned by Department of Tourism and Culture initially. In Konark, we have only group performance of different classical dance styles. But in Mukteshwar, it is only Odissi in different forms like solo, duet and group. But in the evening, as it is a Shiva's temple, so always we begin with an invocation of Lord Shiva.
This year too, a number of mesmerizing performances were presented by some of the talented dancers. One among them was a duet Odissi performed by two young yet powerful dancers, Pritisha Mohapatra and Ribdita Barua. Their presentation started with Shiva's Throtam that describes Shiva's power and beauty, which was then followed by Pallavi, a pure dance item in which Raga is elaborated through eye movements, body postures and intricate footwork. The performance concluded with Sri Ram Bhajan, a piece by a great Hindu poet and saint Tulsidas.
I'm very fortunate that I got an opportunity to perform here. I got an opportunity to perform in this area, that the 100 years old temple, Mukteshwar Temple. Being a part of Mukteshwar Festival is a very proud, very dignified for me.
It was altogether a very different feeling because peeche temple hai, samne aap dance kar rahe ho, और इतने सारे ऑडियंस आए हैं देखने के लिए, विच वॉज नॉट एक्सपेक्टेड कि कोविड के टाइम में भी इतने जन आएंगे, लेकिन अच्छा लगा आए और हमारा प्रोत्साहन बढ़ाया, और डेफिनेटली इट वॉज अ वेरी बिग अपॉर्चुनिटी एंड अ वेरी ग्रेट फीलिंग.
A group dance by Bhubaneswar's prestigious dance institute, Utkal Sangeet Mahavidyalay, was another performance that kept the audience on the edge of their seats. The ensemble's first part was dedicated to Lord Ganesha, followed by Pallavi, and then went on to highlight the various aspects of Shakti. The group captivated the viewers with their classic attire and graceful movements as they tapped their feet to the strokes of the accompanying musical instruments.
बहुत ही अच्छा लग रहा है. कोरोना के बाद पहली बार ओपनली डांस फेस्टिवल अटेंड कर रहे हैं और काफ़ी अच्छा फील हो रहा है. म्यूजिक लाइव लग रहा है, डांस भी काफ़ी अच्छा है. सबसे बेस्ट डांस उड़ीसा का है, मतलब चुने हुए कैंडिडेट कर रहे हैं. हमारे कल्चर के लिए भी काफ़ी इंपॉर्टेंट है. लोग भूल रहे हैं, अटेंड नहीं कर रहे, लेकिन देखिए कितने सारे लोग आज आए हुए हैं. बहुत सारे लोग आए हुए हैं, बहुत सारे लोग सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं, ताली आ रहे हैं.
The Mukteshwar festival is one among a number of successful steps taken by the government of Odisha to attract tourism to the state and spread awareness about its culture and heritage at various national and international platforms.
India is a country where Sufism has not just flourished but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. Even today, the teaching of these saints inform the lives of people and serve as a guiding force. We will take you to one such shrine of Hazrat Shamsuddin Rahmatullah, which is visited by people of all faiths to seek the blessing of holy saint.
Embedded in the bustling lanes of the capital city, New Delhi, the shrine of Sufi saint Hazrat Shamsuddin Utawla Rahmatullah has served as a cynosure of communal harmony for generations, which is thronged by a large number of devotees every day from across the nation, irrespective of their religion. Regarded as one of the greatest Sufi saints, Hazrat Shamsuddin Rahmatullah throughout his life spread the message of Sufism and peace. People of different faiths visit this mighty dargah and perpetuate his teachings of oneness and communal harmony.
ये ऐसी बारगाहें हैं सुकून हासिल करने की जब दुनिया की सारी चीज़ें इंसान के मुजिर और मुआफिक नहीं हुआ करती हैं, तब हिंदू मुस्लिम गैर मुस्लिम सिख ईसाई जिस धर्म के भी हों, वो सारे के सारे अगर किसी जगह का अगर रुख करते हैं, वो यही दरगाहें हैं, यानी कि सूफी संतों की ये बारगाहें हैं.
Located around a kilometer away from Hazrat Nizamuddin Dargah, the Dargah of Hazrat Shamsuddin is also known as Patte Shah's Dargah by the locals. It is believed that the Dargah is built in the Gayaspur village on the order of Tughlaq in 1325 AD. The saint got his name from covering himself with leaves whenever Hazrat Nizamuddin would pass by. The complex of the Dargah also has an 800-year-old tree inside it, which is believed to be there on that spot after the saint buried his datun or toothbrush inside the ground. Devotees of different religious backgrounds come to this Dargah to offer their prayers to the Sufi saint.
सबकी खिदमत करने वाकई हम लोग क्योंकि एक ही चीज़ आता हर किस्म का आदमी आता है. बाहर के भी आते हैं और उन लोगों के भी साथ अच्छे से अच्छा बर्ताव रखना पड़ता है हम लोग.
Since ages, the Sufi saints like Hazrat Shamsuddin Rahmatullah have propagated the message of spiritualism and harmony in our country and their teachings are still playing a significant role in strengthening the threat of secularism.
Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
The skyline above the Golden Temple in Amritsar city of Punjab was filled with colorful fireworks as Sikh devotees observed Guru Parv, the birth anniversary of the 10th and last spiritual leader, Guru Gobind Singh. The temple was decorated with a sea of multicolored lights in the evening, and devotees marked the occasion by lighting earthen oil lamps and then later enjoyed fireworks. Guru Gobind Singh is the 10th Sikh Guru, a warrior, poet, philosopher and son of the revered 9th Sikh Guru Tegh Bahadur, who founded the Sikh warrior community Khalsa in the late 17th century. Indian Army demonstrated the might of their AI-powered combat swarm drones during the Army Day celebrations in New Delhi, in a first for the country's military. The demonstration showcased 75 drones powered by artificial intelligence features that enable them to act autonomously and take down targets including tanks, terror camps, fuel stations, helipads, among others in kamikaze-style attacks. The drones are capable of entering up to 50 km inside enemy territory, carry out independent military attacks and destroy targets along with dropping supplies of up to 600 kg for troops. The technology is indigenously developed and is capable of vertical takeoff from an altitude of up to 4,000 meters above the sea level and can operate at about 1,000 meters from the ground. India has started exporting coronavirus shots with a shipment to the neighboring Himalayan Kingdom of Bhutan. Many low and middle income countries are relying on India, the world's biggest vaccine maker, for supplies to start COVID-19 immunization programs and bring an end to their outbreaks. The ministry has said supplies under grant assistance would be shipped to the Maldives, Bangladesh, Nepal, Myanmar and the Seychelles, while Sri Lanka, Afghanistan and Mauritius await regulatory clearances to receive the vaccines. India authorized 2 vaccines this month for emergency use at home. One licensed from Oxford University and AstraZeneca, and another developed at home by Bharat Biotech in partnership with the state-run Indian Council of Medical Research. Both are manufactured locally. At least 2 other vaccines are expected to be authorized by India in next few months.
India is a country blended with diverse cultures, religions, and traditions. Examples showcasing the peaceful coexistence of different communities at one place have always been a wonder for the people around the world. One such testimony of religious unity is the Goraknath Temple of Uttar Pradesh, which is thronged by people irrespective of their caste and communities. Take a look.
Situated along the banks of Rapti River in Uttar Pradesh, Gorakhpur city is famous as a religious center. Home to Buddhist, Hindu, Jain and Sikh saints, the city is named after a medieval saint, Gorakshanath or Goraknath, in whose honour a famous temple is also built. Standing on 52 acres of the land, the most attractive feature of this temple is the Sanctum Sanctorum, where white marble statue of sage Goraknath performing yogic meditation is enshrined. Though a Hindu religious site, this temple is providing livelihood to hundreds of Muslim families who have been running their shops inside its premises for years, making it an epitome of communal harmony.
हमारी दुकान 30 साल पुरानी है। इसी मंदिर में हम अस्थाई रहते हैं। मेले के दौरान हम लोगों की दुकानें मिलती हैं। अस्थाई की दुकानें दूसरी जगह चेंज हो जाती हैं। और यहाँ कोई दिक्कत नहीं, कोई परेशानी नहीं। हम पुराने यहाँ के निवासी हैं। कोई दिक्कत होने पे हम महाराज से अपनी बात रखते हैं, हमारी बात की जो भी 19-20 होती है उसमें उन्हें देखते हैं।
Every year, The temple hosts the famous Khichdi Parv or Makar Sankranti fair, which lasts for about a month. A number of food stalls and shops are set up around the temple at this time. Be it Hindus, Muslims or people of any other community, everyone becomes a part of the fair. They mingle with each other, shop together and pray together, perfectly packaging a mini India at one place.
बहुत अच्छा लगा. मैं यहीं रहने वाली हूँ. मैं हमेशा आती हूँ. अगली बार में मैं आई थी मेला घूमने. इस बार आके बहुत अच्छा लगा मुझे मेला घूम के. क्या इतना सारा सामान है मेरा, देखिए. हेयरबैंड लिया, कफ लिया, हर चीज़ लिया, घूमा फिरा, झूला झूला, खाना खाया, हर चीज़ खाया. खाया सामने भी खाजे लेके खाएंगे.
देयर आर न्यूमरस रिलीजियस साइट्स इन इंडिया बिलोंगिंग टू वेरियस फेथ्स, बट द वन थिंग दैट कनेक्ट्स देम ऑल is the message of love and brotherhood that they spread. Goraknath Temple is also one among them, which has been for years representing the country's unity in diversity.
Moving on, with changing times, the scenario of Kashmiri music is also evolving. Kashmiri teenagers have started giving modern twists to their usual folk music and have started using internet and social media for showcasing their art. Today, we will meet one such Kashmiri youngster named Adil, who is gaining popularity for reviving Kashmiri music.
A 23-year-old Kashmiri youngster is catching eyeballs for his continuous efforts of reviving Kashmiri folk music. Adil Mansoor, a composer, writer and music director, has decided to leave behind all adversities and make music which encourages other youngsters to get back to their Kashmiri roots.
Fourth class mein tha, mujhe yaad hai. Fir mujhe wahan pe prayer jab hoti hai, to mujhe bolte the ki ye Manzoor Shah ka beta hai, chale ye kuch sunayega. तो फिर मैं नाच पढ़ता था. तब असेंबली लगती थी सुबह सुबह स्कूल में, नाच पढ़ता था. तो वहाँ के हेडमास्टर जो थे, उनने मुझे बोला कि आपकी आवाज़ बहुत अच्छी है और आप अच्छा नाम कमा सकते हो. आप पढ़ो और आगे चल के आप जो सब्जेक्ट है वो म्यूजिक चूज करो.
सन ऑफ अहमद मंजूर शाह, अ रेनाउंड कश्मीरी सिंगर, आदिल इज अ रेसिडेंट ऑफ सिंगपुरा पट्टन, अ स्मॉल विलेज ऑफ बारामूला डिस्ट्रिक्ट. Taking his music education from his father, Adil started putting his music videos on YouTube, which started gaining popularity within no time. Adil's YouTube channel features his Kashmiri folk music. His channel currently has 100,000 subscribers, and one of his duet songs has also touched the 3 million mark. Adil's fellow musicians and friends are extremely proud of him and they see him achieving great heights in the future.
बहुत कम है हमारे यूथ में जो अपने ट्रेडिशंस को, अपने रिवायात को, अपने फोक म्यूजिक को संभाले हुए हैं. और उनमें एक जो बड़ा नाम मैं समझता हूँ कि आज की तारीख में है, वो है आदिल मंजूर शाह. और आदिल मंजूर शाह जिस तरह से कश्मीरी फोक म्यूजिक के लिए काम कर रहे हैं और जो मोहब्बत, जो डेडिकेशन उनमें है, वो शायद मुझे या किसी और फनकार में, जो उभरते हुए फनकार यहाँ पर किसी में दिखाई नहीं दे रहा.
Adil is helping his fellow singers by singing duets and putting those music videos on his YouTube channel. He wishes to bring the upcoming generation of Kashmiris close to their roots and educate them about Kashmiri folk music.
Last but not the least, we bring you a few stories about the recent developments and happenings across Asia in our new edition, Asia in Focus.
China successfully launched a new mobile telecommunication satellite from the Xichang Satellite Launch Center in southwest China's Xichang province. The Tiantong 103 satellite was launched at 12:25 at night by a Long March 3B carrier rocket and entered a planet orbit successfully.
这一发任务呢，应该是中国航天14-5的开局之战。今年呢，西昌卫星发射中心还将承担21次航天发射任务，尤其是空间站3次发射任务，涉及到载人航天工程的进程、目标能否达成。那么我们啊，把年度任务作为一次重大战役。 把空间站任务作为一次重大的战斗，科学筹划，严密实施，要求全体参演参试人员叫响，向天图强，再立新功，航天报国，再创奇迹，并且沉下心思，埋头苦干，从零开始再创辉煌。
The Antong-1 is a satellite mobile communication system independently developed and built by China. It consists of space segment, ground segment and user terminal. Developed by the China Academy of Space Technology, the Tiantong-103 satellite will establish a mobile network with ground facilities to provide all-weather, all-time stable and reliable mobile communication services such as voice, short message and data for users in China and its surrounding areas, the Middle East, Africa and other related regions, as well as mostly areas in the Pacific Ocean and the Indian Ocean. A face mask with an amplifier and microphone that helps in owner sound clearer is a new concept for gaming equipment Maker Razer.
The mask comes in two variants. You have the black mask that comes with a tinted design, and you have a white mask that is completely clear. Now, you can see these are prototypes, and when it comes to the comfort aspect, we spent a lot of time on making sure that you have the right shape and the right silicone padding so that you can wear it for long periods of time.
The waterproof mask is reusable and features medical-grade respiratories, two removable smart ports that the company says filters out at least 95% of airborne particles and can be recharged and disinfected with UV lights in a storage case that comes with the mask. The clear surface is designed to reveal facial expressions, which is held by interior lights in darker conditions. The mask also has exterior lights. The mask developed by Razer's Project Hazel is still a prototype and not yet available for sale. Japan could be turning to the help of robots to help ramp up its COVID-19 testing capabilities. With less than 200 days to go until the Olympic Games are due to start in Tokyo, Japan's health minister watched a demonstration of prototype robotic COVID-19 testing machine that delivers results in about 80 minutes. Kawasaki Heavy Industries, who build the robot system, say it is easily transported and can be set up at stadiums, theme parks and other mass gatherings. Health Minister Nori Hisatamura was seemingly impressed with what he saw. Prime Minister Yoshihide Suga has said his government aims to have the first COVID-19 vaccine approved and rolled out by the end of February, which would be still months behind many other countries.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. To give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I am your host, Emma, and it's a goodbye from the entire production team.